Lucas Indian Services is one of the leading players in aftermarket space. Today we are joined by Mr. S. Muralidharan, President, Lucas Indian Services. Welcome to ET Auto, sir.
Thank you.
Press the bell icon and never miss an update from ET Auto.
You are one of the thriving forces in automotive aftermarket. Can you please give us some sense how the market is moving? What is going to be the future like?
The Indian automotive aftermarket is moving through a very exciting phase, clearly so. You have three generations of technology, BS4 vehicles, BS4 becoming BS6. Old vehicles are already there. You have multi-channel two-wheelers, three-wheelers, cars, trucks and buses. You also have electric vehicles on the horizon. There could be a temporary blip now due to liquidity on the level of growth, but we are quite bullish that in the CAGR of the next 3, 4, 5 years will clearly be double digit. It's a very large market, 56,000 crores is what is estimated. Yes, intensely competitive, increasingly more intensely competitive, more technology driven, but I think that's all part of the excitement of the game. Part of the game, good excitement.
How do you look at the growth plan when it comes to market like India? You have already one joint venture with a leading company in the country. Do you want to take this relationship further? Are you exploring a new alliance, new collaboration in the country, probably a new service? You have multiple service overseas.
Yeah, clearly multi-brand. So we have strong understanding, not just with our group companies, of course we have Lucas TVS, but a strong understanding with other brands like Delphi, CAV, Indian Nippon. We also market NSK products, Gates, Beru. So a very wide range of brands is in our portfolio. This direction will continue, whichever way, whatever it is. In terms of channel, again, we want to be more multi-channel. Traditionally, we were commercial vehicles. In the last couple of years, we started in two-wheelers, and that has shown exponential growth. It's really so, very, very strong levels of growth. We'll continue in that direction. As far as two-wheelers is concerned, we're also looking at two-wheeler bike service in a much more rapid way. So that is in terms of service. Cars, we may be a lower player, but we have recently introduced a car scanner, car dongle called Car Plus, which will help in the middle kind of garages for diagnostics. It is not top end, but for the mass garages, it is a big boom. So across all channels, we'll be expanding multi-brand, multi-channel. In terms of geography, we are very widely dispersed already.
You are an expert in this space. You have spent decades and you have been associated with one of the top brands, not one, but many top brands in this space. What is your assessment? Why we do not see much of multi-brand service doing so well? We have seen one of them just being acquired by a company after they failed to have a business that could sustain.
I'm not too sure if we can say multi-brand services, because I don't know if there are really very many multi-brand services. Most of them have one mega brand name. So people think with that one mega brand, all the parts used will be with that one mega brand. So multi-point service in the true sense of the word has possibly not reached India. So you still have organized players, which can be the OEMs or some of these car dealerships. It can be the better quality dealerships of cars, better quality car garages, or less organized ones. I think the true multi-brand services has still not really entered India. I do not consider, for example, Carnation or Bosch car service as multi-brand service. As long as you have that one mega brand in the front, it will be seen as that mega brand's car service.
How does Lucas look at multi-brand services?
Very positively. We support all these organizations. We support this All India Association of Workshops, Garages. We support them tremendously because I think that's where the future is. forever you're going to have car services which are with OEMs and car services with organized independent garages. So until and unless you support these organized garages, help them in training, not just products, help them in training, help them in marketing. Unless you do that, the future of companies like LIS will be tricky. But you support them, both of them will have a win-win. You have to go to garages, not just cars. It can be two-wheelers, it can be tractors, it can also be, of course, trucks and buses.
So do you have any concrete plan also to probably get into service also? Like your some of your rivals have some of the service station, service models. You also probably have in overseas markets. Do you want to bring something of that sort to India also?
We have recently set up a tie-up with WAPCO for services. We have tried it out in north, in and around Delhi, in Faridabad. That will definitely be an expansion plan over the course of this calendar year. The issue is not just the brand of service. You'll certainly do that. The issue is there's a fleet operator. He has a problem. It could be a starting problem. We position ourselves as an aftermarket solutions provider, which means whether the starting problem is because of starter, alternator, wiring harness, battery, switch, we should provide it. It's whether the issue is because of pump, high pressure pipe, or a WAPCO product, we should solve it. So the issue is, what is the key pain point of a fleet operator, and can we have solutions for it? In the process, whatever brands we need, we will do.
Lucas Indian Services was also looking at some venturing into EV space. How is that working?
We will service any vehicle. We don't call it as automotive anymore. It's mobility solutions. You know, we do service e-rickshaws in states of UP. We do have e-rickshaw batteries for such customers. We'll also have certain other components which can retrofit or service in markets where the e-rickshaws are high, or for that matter, e-bikes are high. So we have gradually entered that space. I'm quite bullish about it. I think as that market grows, LIS will be part of the growth. And since we'll be relative early entrance, I see very long-term possibilities in it.
If you look at the market, it is quite a threshold of major change that is going to come. What are the two, three trends that you know that will be a very, very important factor in automotive aftermarket space, and that will impact hugely? And the people should be ready to embrace that change, and how?
One is digitization. It can be a huge disruptor to the extent that it can even change the business models. Digitization will delayer the network. It will delayer also the suppliers. Anybody can come to us and say, this is the product we can, because you're already offering it. It can delayer. Digitization should be embraced so that we see it as an opportunity and not as a threat. Second, as a consequence, technology change. BS4, BS6, when people are not even had BS2, BS3 vehicles done. And then you suddenly have also cars with need higher diagnostic, and now suddenly you're going to have electric vehicles. To cope with this kind of technology, I don't know if all the garages are equipped, either with equipment or with skilled people. People who have learned mechanics trade, to do a car scanner on electronics, or to do a servicing of an electric vehicle, needs enormous skilling efforts. So these are the two basic things. First, it's digitization will lead to changes. Second, technology. Of course, now GST has stabilized, but if we are not prompt in supply chain, today nobody talks of weeks for supplies, nobody talks of days.
Where Lucas looks at itself in India, what is the rightful place in terms of revenue, in terms
leader.
Of market share?
Clear leader.
And how long do you think you'll be taking to reach there?
We feel we are in the top few already, top two, three. Our benchmarks are now the very large OEMs. They are the people we chase in terms of revenue, and that's what we will do. So,
any investment outlay that you have to achieve that?
We'll invest in a network, we'll invest in digitization, we'll invest in supply chain aspects
How
tremendously.
Much?
our investments are peanuts. They're all rupees.
Okay.
The investment finally is human capital. What we want is somebody should, Shati Pitokik and I am working in LIS, and this is the value I bring to society. So our investment will be in people. And I think that is where the game changer would be. You have good people right across the value chain, and you keep training them, keep improving the standards.
Will you choose to be a disruptor? Or you because it's all about disruptions.
We have no choice. We have been growing in the last few years because in our own way, we are a disruptor. The question is, are you going to be a disruptor like a ship, or are you going to be a disruptor like a submarine? We prefer to be submarines. That's a change.
Thank you so much. Wish you all the very best.